do things right, one must take their time. In a hurried pace, there's often...
Explain to you real quick what happened there. Amazing, amen, who had put on the garment of Joab. And the Bible said that when he put on the garment of Joab, amen, it had a sword in it, amen, that was girt about the loins. Amen. I kind of got a stick here representing the sword, all right? And he had on the garment of Joab, Amazah did. And in that garment was a sword. And the Bible said the sword was in the sheath. Amen. And somewhere along the way, amen, that sword, it fell out. Amen. And he did not know, amen, that it had fallen out. And but I want you to just picture here, amen, and consider something. Amen. First of all, amen, the owner of this garment was not Amazah. Amen, the owner of the sword, amen, was not Amazah. Amen, the owner of these things, amen, was another man. And I'd like to preach, if I can tonight, amen, that the owner knows better what to do with what is his. And friend, now I want you to think about this, amen, because what we see in the world today, if we're not careful, we have come out of the world to be separate, saith the Lord. Amen, but if we're not careful, we went back, amen, to the things of the world. And the owner of that world, amen, sees you as you partake of the things that belong to him. Amen, he sees you as you partake. Amen, and friend, can I say it? Amen, the anger of our lives, amen, the lust of our flesh, amen, the envy of our heart, amen, the covetousness, amen, of our soul, all of these things are not godly. Amen, if it's not of God, then it belongs to the world. And the owner of that, amen, knows how to use that, amen, greater than you do. And I want you to think about what happened, amen, whenever the owner of the sword, amen, seen it laying on the ground, he picked it back up. He walked up to Amazah. Come here if you would. And he picks up the sword that Amazah did not know had fallen. And he gives him by the beard. And he acts like he's going to give him a kiss. And he thrusts it into his rib, and he dies. Now come on, church, let me talk to you. If you have something in your life, amen, that you are not the owner of, amen, it will destroy you. If you have something in your life, amen, that is not of God, it is of the world, amen, it will be your downfall. Amen, it will cause you, amen, to lose your very soul, amen, in eternity, amen. And he carried with him a sword that he did not own. Amen. And he did not know it was even there. Amen. But the enemy, amen, when he saw the sword, he said, that belongs to me. Amen. And he took it and he killed the man. Friend, listen to me. We live in a world, a church world, that says it's all right, amen, to live like, talk like, and act like the world. Amen. But I'm here to say the owner of those things, amen, the devil knows how to use them in your life, and he will use them to destroy you. If you've got anger, you better get the anger out of your heart. If you've got lust, you better get the lust out of your heart. The owner knows how to use it. Ooh, I ain't gonna get any amens. Yeah, but you're gonna get the word tonight. There was a man in the Word of God by the name of Balaam. Balaam had something in his heart that shouldn't have been there. They came to him and they said, there are men coming about of the land of Egypt. Curse them. Oh, this man of God got down on his knees and said, Father, they want me to curse. What do I do? And the Lord spoke to him. And the Lord said, curse them not. I have blessed them. Come on now. He walks out and he looks at these men. And he says, I cannot curse them. I cannot curse what God has blessed. So they went home. But when they came back, amen, with people of great esteem. Amen, people, amen, of great reputation, and they asked him again, will you curse? Come on now, you know what he did? Amen. He had in his heart, amen, a spirit, amen, that liked to be exalted. He had in his heart a spirit, amen, that says, I want to fit in. I want to be like them. Amen. I want them. My goodness, look who that is. And he got down on his knees and he prayed again. Father, woo, let me, amen, curse them. Church, let me talk to you. Amen. Whenever the devil is calling the shots in your life, whenever the devil is having you, amen, to choose, amen, the worldly over the godly, amen, the devil knows how to use it, amen, what belongs to him. That exalted spirit got a hold of him. The next thing you know, he's on a mule and he's headed to the enemy's camp. My God had just told him, I will not allow you to curse them. He said, whatever words I tell you, you speak those words and nothing else. Along the way, that donkey that he was on saw something in the way. I can see that donkey starting to fight a little bit. And it gets a little closer. And it fights a little more. And it gets a little closer. Balaam is sitting there beating that donkey. Amen, beating that donkey. The next thing you know, amen, it hits his foot up against a wall. Oh, he gets off and he starts beating that donkey. But God gave it a voice and it began to speak. Woo! Hallelujah. Church, let me talk to you. The very ones trying to help you, if you ain't careful, is the one you will call your enemy. The very one, amen, trying to keep you from destruction, is the very one, amen, that you'll talk about and ridicule. The very one looking out for your soul is the very one. If you're not careful, amen, you'll beat on. Come on, I'm talking to somebody tonight. You better get it under control. Amen, the devil knows how to use it. The devil knows what is his, and he knows how to destroy you. The owner of that sword knew how to use that sword. He packed it around to his own destruction. He never took it himself out of the sheath. Come on, he may not even knew it was there. Amen, but all of a sudden, it hits the ground. And Joab sees his opportunity, and he picked it up. Woo, glory. Come on. Then he walks up and says, let me give you a kiss. Amen, he took, amen, what was his, that was in the possession, amen, of this man of God, and he killed him. Friend, if it's in your possession and it don't belong to you, it belongs to the world. I promise you, the devil's looking for an opportunity to use that to destroy you. He beats this mule. He begins to speak. Have I ever done you wrong? Why do you beat me? Huh? Haven't I always done what you told me to do? And God opened his eyes. And when God opened his eyes, he saw an angel. The angel wasn't going, the angel had a sword. And it was about to slay him. Come on, if he would have taken another step, hey man, the angel would have slew him. Come on, church, I want to talk to you here. Hey man, he had in his heart an exalted spirit. Hey man, it didn't belong to him. That ain't godly. That belongs in the world. But it was on the man of God. Hey man, and he carried it around. Hey man, what happened to him? I don't know why. I can't figure out how. How many of you, hey man, if that would have happened to you, amen, would have looked at them men and said, I ain't going another step with you. I'm headed back home. But that man didn't do that. He said, all right, fellas, amen, let's go on in our journey. And he went on, amen, in his journey, amen, to that pagan country. You know what happened to him? Amen, in the Bible speaks of a battle that took place in that pagan land. And it says Balaam died amongst the enemy. Woo! Hold on, listen to me. It was his demise. He allowed that exalted spirit to keep him moving down a road he knew he ought not to do. And the devil knew how to use that. It was his. He exalted himself above, amen, all that is godly. Amen. He lifted himself up and said, I am the greatest of them all. Can I talk to you? Amen. The devil owns it, and he knows how to use it, and he will destroy you. Let me read you something. Some of the things the devil owns: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envies, murders, drunkenness, revelings. How many knows what revelings is, in case you don't know? Loud, boisterous celebrations. Huh? Parties. Ooh. How many went, oh. Huh? Yeah. But the Bible says, these are the works of the flesh. The things that don't belong to a child of God. Come on, if you got them on you, the devil knows how to use them. Amen, to destroy you. Amen, I got some more. Amen, mortify. Amen, it says fornications, uncleanness, evil conceptions. Amen, covetousness, idolatry, wrath, malice, anger, blasphemy, filthy communication. Come on now, that's just a few of the things. Amen, few of the swords, if you will. Amen, that the devil owns. Amen, that he is just waiting on you to pick up. Amen, and start carrying with you. Amen, knowing that somewhere along the way, amen, you're going to drop it. Somewhere along the way, he's going to have the opportunity to pick it up and bring you down in your demise. That's why the Bible says, come out of the world and be separate, saith the Lord. Touch not, taste not, handle not. Amen, but if we're not careful, amen, we have in our hearts, amen, the Samson syndrome. Amen, we think we can run around with the enemy. We think, amen, that we're strong enough and mighty enough, amen, to overcome. Amen, we think, amen, that no way that little girl, amen, could do anything to harm me. And we walk around, amen, with the devil's sword, and we wonder why we've lost our strength. Church, in a world where the Bible says there will be a great falling away, where are you at? Where's your affections? Where's your heart? Our affections need to be on the things that are above. But if we're not careful, we never think about church or anything in the church until we walk through the door of the church. Huh? If we're not careful, amen, we spend our entire day, amen, trying to heap up, amen, store up, and celebrate up the world into our lives. Amen, and this man had on a garment that did not belong to him. Amen, and in it was something that the devil knew how to use. And friend, if you are not careful, we'll place upon us, amen, the very garment of the world. Amen, we'll put upon us, amen, the very, amen, very things, amen, the adulteries and the hatreds, the envies, amen, all these things, amen, they're of the world, amen, but if we are not careful, amen, we've got something that the devil knows how to use. We don't own it, he owns it. Amen, another place in the Word, it talks about how, amen, there was a man, oh my goodness, Lord of mercy, friend, I want you to think about this, amen, because too many times, amen, the people of God allow themselves to be deceived. Too many times we allow ourselves to think, amen, that we're stronger than, mightier than. I'll guarantee you, amen, go find anybody that is backslidden and ask them, do you think you would have backslid when you did? I guarantee you, they all would have said, I never dreamed that would happen. Huh? They all would have told you, I dreamed I would stand for the Lord all the days of my life. The Bible says a man by the name of Korah, amen, rose up. Oh, You know what he did? He labeled it as good. How many knows why Korah rose up? Let me tell you what he said. Korah looked at Moses, and he said, "Moses, you're a holy man. But you know what, Moses? We're as holy as you are. And the people are as holy as you are. So we're going to help you out. We can talk to God the same way as you can. Hey, preacher, we don't need you to preach to us. Huh? Hey, we can do it ourselves. We're in control ourselves. We can work it out ourselves. Come on, friend, I'm talking to somebody here. If you're not careful, something has got out of control in your life. Amen. I think about whenever Absalom grabbed that mule, amen, and began to ride upon that mule. How many know, heard the word stubborn as a mule? You know why they say stubborn as a mule? If a mule don't want to do it, my goodness, you ain't going to get it to do it. It'll sit down on you. You can tug, you can pull. Amen. You can do whatever you want. Amen. And the Bible says that he was on a mule and he was riding. The enemy was chasing him. Amen. And he was trying to go this way, and all of a sudden that mule, amen, decided, "I'm going through this thick bull, amen, and you know what, there's somebody on my back, I'm going to get him off." Amen. He went through that, and Absalom got caught in the tree, amen, between the fork of a tree on his neck, amen, and he got hung in the tree. What are you saying, Brother Gary? It got out of control. Amen. What he thought he could control got out of control, and the next thing you know, he's hanging in a tree. Amen. Without any hope. Friend, listen. You cannot control the world. Amen. All you can do is get it out of your life. Amen. You cannot control envy, hatred. Amen. Anger. Amen. You cannot control it. You got to mortify it. You've got to kill it. Amen. You got to get it out of your life. How many knows there's people, and I don't know why I'm saying this, it just came to me, who own lions as pets. You know why they own them? They're convinced that they can control them. They're convinced that that lion would never turn against them, that that lion actually loves the way they love. Same thing with snakes. Right? People own snakes. True story, just in case you ain't heard this, there was a lady owned a python, I guess it was. And it was longer than her. And true story, she let it run, she let it crawl around in the house or slither. And she woke up one day, and often she found it in her bed, but this time it was stretched out beside of her. I mean, down from her feet up to her head. And she thought, "Man, my snake is sick." Huh? And so she thought, I'm gonna take him to the vet. Well, the next night it happened again. And this snake was laying out beside of her. I mean, stretched out like a stick right beside of her. And she said, "I've done it, I'm taking it." And she took it to the vet. She said, "My python is sick." He said, "What's it doing?" She said, "Every time I wake up, it lays stretched out beside of me." He said, "Your python ain't sick. Your python is measuring you up to see if he can eat you. Come on now." He said, "You better get rid of that thing. Hey man, it ain't sick. Hey man, it's been around long enough, and it's got big enough it thinks. Hey man, it can take you. Hey man, if you don't get rid of it, it will kill you." Friend, I'm preaching to somebody the same thing. If you don't get the anger, you don't get the lust, amen, you don't take the malice, the envy, amen, if you don't get these things out of your life, amen, they do not belong to you. And the one that they belong to knows how to use them. Amen. And he'll find you in a weak moment. Amen. And he'll use that, amen, to kill you. Amen. But God has sent a message tonight. Amen. He gave this to me yesterday. He said, "Preach it tonight." And I'm telling somebody, amen, it's in your life. You need to get it out. Come on, brother. Brother Gary, I don't know what to do. How many knows what the word sanctification means? Let me just say it like this. How many knows it's spring cleaning time? Another week or two, brothers, get ready. It's going to come. We've already started on the outside. Right? My wife was out there yesterday sweeping and raking, and I mean, she's doing all kinds of stuff. Hey, amen. I don't know what I was doing. It wasn't that, though. Spring cleaning time. Right? I'm in trouble probably. I don't know it yet. Amen. But, amen, it's spring cleaning time. That's what sanctification is. Amen. You go into your life and you say, Lord, I want to look into my heart. Lord, tell me, do I have anything in there? Is there something I do not own? Amen. Something that belongs to the devil. Amen. And it's in there with me. Amen. Is it there? Come on now, because if it is, the devil's waiting for that perfect opportunity. Amen. For him to take that belongs to him, that he knows how to use it and to destroy you. Come on, I like to say it like this. Amen. When you read about Laban and him chasing after Jacob, you know why he chased after Jacob? Amen. There was a reason. Jacob didn't know it. Amen. Because his wife, amen, Laban's daughter, had stolen an idol. Amen. And the Bible said, amen, he found them gone and found that idol missing and started chasing them. You say, Brother Gary, the devil fights me every day. Maybe you got something that belongs to him. Amen. Maybe there's something in your life, amen, that keeps him chasing after you. Amen. Get it out of your life. Amen. If you don't own anything that belongs to him, amen, then he has no reason, amen, to try to use it against you. Mordecai looked out one day, and a man named Haman was looking at him. And Haman said, bow to me. And Mordecai said, I bow to nobody but God. Anger rose up in Haman's life. He became possessed with killing Mordecai. Come on now. He had such anger in him. Amen. That's all. He even devised a plot how he could kill Mordecai. And not just Mordecai, but all of the Jews. Come on now. He built a gallows. Amen. 30 feet high. Come on down. Let me just say this. A 10-foot high gallows will kill, amen, just as good, amen, as a 15, 20, or 30. Amen. This man didn't just want him to drop. Amen. He wanted to see him drop, amen, a long ways. Amen. Know that there's terror in his heart as he drops a long ways. Amen. He was full of such anger, amen, that he built a bed, and he said, amen, had the king to even write a decree that said that anybody that was a Jew, amen, could die upon that. Oh, but let me talk to you here. Amen, that anger didn't belong to God. Amen, that anger, amen, didn't belong to God. Amen, it wasn't his, but the enemy knew how to use that. So we read that the king couldn't sleep one night, and when he couldn't sleep, the Lord had him to read a book, amen, of all of the notes that were taken, and he read in that. He said, huh, Mordecai saved my life. I didn't know that. And he called for the men. He said, who is this Mordecai? And when did he save my life? And they told the story about how treachery had taken place, and Mordecai had known about it and let them know, and the king's life was spared. And the king called Haman in, the one who wanted to kill Mordecai. And he says, Haman, there's a man I need to honor. What do you think I should do? Haman said, he's talking about me. So he says, make him second ruler in all of the camp, in all the land. Set him upon a horse and ride him throughout all the camp and say that God, that the king honors this man. He said, that's a good idea, Haman. Amen. Haman went out thinking, woo, man, I'm about to have a good time tomorrow. And then he calls him back in the next day and he says, I want you to go get this man named Mordecai and put him upon the horse. Woo! Let me just tell you the long story and make it short. They took Haman out and he walked up that 30 steps or 50 steps or whatever it is to get 30 foot high, and the noose was put around his neck. Amen. And Haman, amen, oh, I mean, he's heard that old saying, give them enough rope and they'll hang themselves. Amen. The devil, amen, if you're not careful, he's saying, go a little further, go a little further. Amen. If you go a little further, I've got got you. Church, I'm talking to somebody. His anger got a hold of him, and his anger, amen, had him killed. Why? Amen, because the devil, amen, knew how to use what belongs to him. And friend, I'm here to preach to somebody. Amen, you better get it out of your life.
Let me slow. Jealousy is not of God. Envy is not of God. Variance causing division all the time. It's not of God. Huh? Tail bearers. Huh? Ooh. Not of God. Lust, envy, strife. Oh, you say, Brother Gary, we all talk about adultery and fornication, and you know what? Them ain't of God either. But it's the small foxes that spoil the vine. Those little things. Amen. That sword, amen, in that whole garment was small compared to that whole garment. But it was big enough for the devil to know how to use it. Come on, and he took that, amen, and he killed that man. Church, listen to me, amen. The last one I wanted to mention, amen, was how a woman looked out of a window, and she had trusted all of her life in her, amen, in her appearance, in her look.
Let's
do things right, one must take their time. In a hurried pace, there's often...
Let me explain to you real quick what happened there. Amazing, amen, who had put on the garment of Joab. And the Bible said that when he put on the garment of Joab, amen, it had a sword in it, amen, that was girt about the loins. Amen. I kind of got a stick here representing the sword, all right? And he had on the garment of Joab, Amazah did. And in that garment was a sword. And the Bible said the sword was in the sheath. Amen. And somewhere along the way, amen, that sword, it fell out. Amen. And he did not know, amen, that it had fallen out. And I want you to just picture here, amen, and consider something. Amen. First of all, amen, the owner of this garment was not Amazah. Amen, the owner of the sword, amen, was not Amazah. Amen, the owner of these things, amen, was another man. And I'd like to preach, if I can tonight, amen, that the owner knows better what to do with what is his. And friend, now I want you to think about this, amen, because what we see in the world today, if we're not careful, we have come out of the world to be separate, saith the Lord. Amen, but if we're not careful, we've went back, amen, to the things of the world. And the owner of that world, amen, sees you as you partake of the things that belong to him. Amen, he sees you as you partake. Amen, and friend, can I say it? Amen, the anger of our lives, amen, the lust of our flesh, amen, the envy of our heart, amen, the covetousness, amen, of our soul, all of these things are not godly. Amen, if it's not of God, then it belongs to the world. And the owner of that, amen, knows how to use that, amen, greater than you do. And I want you to think about what happened, amen, whenever the owner of the sword, amen, seen him laying on the ground, he picked it back up. He walked up to Amazah. Come here if you would. And he picks up the sword that Amazah did not know had fallen. And he gives him by the beard. And he acts like he's going to give him a kiss. And he thrusts it into his rib. And he dies. Now come on, church, let me talk to you. If you have something in your life, amen, that you are not the owner of, amen, it will destroy you. If you have something in your life, amen, that is not of God, it is of the world, amen, it will be your downfall. Amen, it will cause you, amen, to lose your very soul, amen, in eternity. Amen, he carried with him a sword that he did not own, amen, and he did not know it was even there. Amen, but the enemy, amen, when he saw the sword, he said, that belongs to me. Amen, and he took it and he killed the man. Friend, listen to me. We live in a world, a church world, that says it's all right, amen, to live like, talk like, and act like the world. Amen, but I'm here to say the owner of those things, amen, the devil knows how to use them in your life, and he will use them to destroy you. If you've got anger, you better get the anger out of your heart. If you've got lust, you better get the lust out of your heart. The owner knows how to use it. Ooh, I ain't gonna get any amens. Yeah, but you're gonna get the word tonight. There was a man in the Word of God by the name of Balaam. Balaam had something in his heart that shouldn't have been there. They came to him and they said, there are men coming about of the land of Egypt. Curse them. Oh, this man of God got down on his knees and said, Father, they want me to curse. What do I do? And the Lord spoke to him. And the Lord said, curse them not. I have blessed them. Come on now. He walks out and he looks at these men and he says, I cannot curse them. I cannot curse what God has blessed. So they went home. But when they came back, amen, with people of great esteem. amen, people, amen, of great reputation, and they asked him again, will you curse? Come on now, you know what he did? Amen, he had in his heart, amen, a spirit, amen, that liked to be exalted. He had in his heart a spirit, amen, that says, I want to fit in. I want to be like them. Amen, I want them. My goodness, look who that is. And he got down on his knees, and he prayed again, Father, let me, amen, curse them. Church, let me talk to you. Amen, whenever the devil is calling the shots in your life, whenever the devil is having you, amen, to choose, amen, the worldly over the godly, amen, the devil knows how to use it, amen, what belongs to him. That exalted spirit got a hold of him. The next thing you know, he's on a mule, and he's headed to the enemy's camp. My God had just told him, I will not allow you to curse them. He said, whatever words I tell you, you speak those words and nothing else. Along the way, that donkey that he was on saw something in the way. I can see that donkey starting to fight a little bit. And it gets a little closer. And it fights a little more. And it gets a little closer. Balaam is sitting there beating that donkey. Amen, beating that donkey. The next thing you know, amen, it hits his foot up against a wall. Oh, he gets off and he starts beating that donkey. But God gave it a voice and it began to speak. Woo! Hallelujah. Church, let me talk to you. The very ones trying to help you, if you ain't careful, is the one you will call your enemy. The very one, amen, trying to keep you from destruction, is the very one, amen, that you'll talk about and ridicule. The very one looking out for your soul is the very one. If you're not careful, amen, you'll beat on. Come on, I'm talking to somebody tonight. You better get it under control. Amen, the devil knows how to use it. The devil knows what is his, and he knows how to destroy you. The owner of that sword knew how to use that sword. He packed it around to his own destruction. He never took it himself out of the sheath. Come on, he may not even knew it was there. Amen, but all of a sudden, it hits the ground. Joab see his opportunity, and he picked it up. Woo, glory. Come on. Then he walks up and says, let me give you a kiss. Amen, he took, amen, what was his that was in the possession, amen, of this man of God, and he killed him. Friend, if it's in your possession and it don't belong to you, it belongs to the world. I promise you, the devil's looking for an opportunity to use that to destroy you. He beats this mule. He begins to speak. Have I ever done you wrong? Why do you beat me? Huh? Haven't I always done what you told me to do? And God opened his eyes. And when God opened his eyes, he saw an angel. The angel wasn't going, the angel had a sword. And it was about to slay him. Come on, if he would have taken another step, amen, the angel would have slew him. Come on, church, I want to talk to you here. Amen, he had in his heart an exalted spirit. Amen, it didn't belong to him. That ain't godly. That belongs in the world. But it was on the man of God. Amen, and he carried it around. Amen, what happened to him? I don't know why. I can't figure out how. How many of you, amen, if that would have happened to you, amen, would have looked at them men and said, I ain't going another step with you. I'm headed back home. But that man didn't do that. He said, all right, fellas, amen, let's go on in our journey. And he went on, amen, in his journey, amen, to that pagan country. You know what happened to him? Amen, in the Bible speaks of a battle that took place in that pagan land. And it says Balaam died amongst the enemy. Woo! Hold on, listen to me. It was his demise. He allowed that exalted spirit to keep him moving down a road he knew he ought not to do. And the devil knew how to use that. It was his. He exalted himself above, amen, all that is godly. Amen. He lifted himself up and said, I am the greatest of them all. Can I talk to you? Amen. The devil owns it, and he knows how to use it, and he will destroy you.
Let me read you something. Some of the things the devil owns: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions, heresies, envies, murders, drunkenness, revelings. How many knows what revelings is, in case you don't know? Loud, boisterous celebrations. Huh? Parties. Woo. How many went, oh. Huh? Yeah. What the Bible says. These are the works of the flesh. The things that don't belong to a child of God. Come on, if you got them on you, the devil knows how to use them. Amen, to destroy you. Amen, I got some more. Amen, mortify. Amen, it says fornications, uncleanness, evil conceptions. Amen, covetousness, idolatry, wrath, malice, anger, blasphemy, filthy communication. Come on now, that's just a few of the things. Amen, few of the swords, if you will. Amen, that the devil owns. Amen, that he is just waiting on you to pick up. Amen, and start carrying with you. Amen, knowing that somewhere along the way, amen, you're going to drop it. Somewhere along the way, he's going to have the opportunity to pick it up and bring you down in your demise. That's why the Bible says, come out of the world and be separate, saith the Lord. Touch not, taste not, handle not. Amen, but if we're not careful, amen, we have in our hearts, amen, the Samson syndrome. Amen, we think we can run around with the enemy. We think, amen, that we're strong enough and mighty enough, amen, to overcome. Amen, we think, amen, that no way that little girl, amen, could do anything to harm me. And we walk around, amen, with the devil's sword, and we wonder why we've lost our strength.
Church, in a world where the Bible says there will be a great falling away. Where are you at? Where's your affections? Where's your heart? Our affections need to be on the things that are above. But if we're not careful, we never think about church or anything in the church until we walk through the door of the church. Huh? If we're not careful, amen, we spend our entire day, amen, trying to heap up, amen, store up, and celebrate up the world into our lives. Amen, and this man had on a garment that did not belong to him. Amen, and in it was something that the devil knew how to use. And friend, if you are not careful, we'll place upon us, amen, the very garment of the world. Amen, we'll put upon us, amen, the very, amen, very things, amen, the adulteries and the hatreds, the envies, amen, all these things, amen, that are of the world, amen. But if we are not careful, amen, we've got something that the devil knows how to use. We don't own it, he owns it. Amen. Another place in the word, it talks about how, amen, there was a man, oh my goodness, Lord of mercy. Friend, I want you to think about this, amen, because too many times, amen, the people of God allow themselves to be deceived. Too many times we allow ourselves to think, amen, that we're stronger than, mightier than. I'll guarantee you, amen, go find anybody that is backslidden and ask them, do you think you would have backslid when you did?
I guarantee you, they all would have said, I never dreamed that would happen. Huh? They all would have told you, I dreamed I would stand for the Lord all the days of my life. The Bible says a man by the name of Korah, amen, rose up. Oh, You know what he did? He labeled it as good. How many knows why Korah rose up? Let me tell you what he said. Korah looked at Moses and he said, Moses, you're a holy man. But you know what, Moses? We're as holy as you are. And the people are as holy as you are. So we're going to help you out. We can talk to God the same way as you can. Hey, preacher, we don't need you to preach to us. Huh? Hey, we can do it ourselves. We're in control ourselves. We can work it out ourselves. Come on, friend, I'm talking to somebody here. If you're not careful, something has got out of control in your life. Amen. I think about whenever Absalom grabbed that mule. Amen. And began to ride upon that mule. How many know heard the word stubborn as a mule? You know why they say stubborn as a mule? If a mule don't want to do it, my goodness, you ain't going to get it to do it. It'll sit down on you. You can tug. You can pull. Amen. You can do whatever you want. Amen. And the Bible says that he was on a mule and he was riding. The enemy was chasing him. Amen. And he was trying to go this way, and all of a sudden that mule, amen, decided, I'm going through this thick bowl, amen, and you know what, there's somebody on my back, I'm going to get him off, amen. He went through that, and Absalom got caught in the tree, amen, between the fork of a tree on his neck, amen, and he got hung in the tree. What are you saying, Brother Gary? It got out of control, amen. What he thought he could control got out of control, and the next thing you know, he's hanging in a tree. Amen. Without any hope. Friend, listen. You cannot control the world. Amen. All you can do is get it out of your life. Amen. You cannot control envy, hatred. Amen. Anger. Amen. You cannot control it. You got to mortify it. You've got to kill it. Amen. You got to get it out of